You, yes you, edit video inside Premiere, Final Cut or DaVinci. Well, here's the pack with over 10,000 drag and drop visual effects you can use to level up your editing speed. Inside this pack, you get over thousands of overlays and textures like this dust overlays, haze, anamorphic flare, and much more. 400 transitions like these 3D zoom effects. It also includes over 2,500 sound effects to use, and not to mention thousands of these cinematic LUTs you also get from this pack. And I mean 10,000 assets, Cinepunch. Let's get into it. Once you purchase and download the pack, inside the folder, they have separated into three main elements: transition effects, overlays, and LUTs. To install the transition effects is pretty straightforward. You drag it into the Fusion page, or simply double-click the DRFX file. Then all the transition effects will be shown under Video Transitions inside the Effects tab. Then other effects will be shown in the Effects. For the overlays and sound effects, they include all of them in a project file, so you need to import the project into DaVinci. So you right-click on the Project Manager, Import Project. Choose the DRP file in the folder. Then inside the project, relink the media file, right click on Cinepunch bin, then choose relink clip for selected bin, choose Cinepunch folder. Then you enable power bin, drag everything into it, so you can use it in other future projects within the same database. Then for the LUTs pack, open the project setting at the bottom right to the color management, then hit open LUTs folder. Drag this LUT master folder into that folder, then hit update list. Then all the LUTs will be installed inside the color page. Once all is set, let's see what they got. For the transition effects, I can say that they included almost every single transition effects you can find on the market right now. One of my favorite transition effects is the camera shake, which you can adjust the speed, invert animation, blur amount, strength, and flash. Fade transition that are not the same as DaVinci fade, which is kinda cool if you use it to showcase some color grading work. Zoom, where you can adjust the pivot point, quality, and shutter angle of the motion blur. They also give you a bunch of disruption effects, like this signal scratch, video damage, or this record overlay, or even this analog noise. And not to mention that all of these, you can adjust the elements inside using the inspector on your edit page. Now, the next one is one of the greatest things, and it is the selling point of this pack, overlays. For example, Cine Dust. Let's say you want to add some particles and make your scene more appealing. So you drag the video into the timeline, then open the inspector under retime and scaling, change the scaling to fill, then change the composite to either add or screen. If it's too much, you can always reduce the opacity down, then change the speed of the overlays as you like. Another one that I like is the haze overlay to create some atmosphere, which, similar to Cine Dust, you drag the video into the timeline, then change the scaling to fill, and the composite to either add or screen, then play with the speed as you like. And there's a film punch. Let's say if you want to add some texture to your footage, like this, this, or this. Filmmaker overlay, like this flicker, this lights flare, and much, much more. Another big one they include in the pack is they give you over 800 LUTs to use in your projects. And since they did not mention what color space or gamma the LUTs are, I would assume it's Rec. 709. Which means that if you have log footage, you need to convert it to a Rec. 709 first, whether by using a camera LUTs or CST, then apply the LUTs following that node, and do any adjustment before the transform node. And since I'm a colorist, it's pretty serious for me to inform you that, to be honest, I don't really have a good feeling with LUTs that doesn't tell you any color space. So how do we know whether it's a good or a bad LUTs? If we take the LUTs and apply it to a grayscale, and if you look at the waveform, if you know, you know. But if you really need to use one of these LUTs, seriously, one way to maximize it is to create a parallel node and change the composite of the top node to luminosity and the bottom one to color. Then whatever LUTs you put at the top will only affect the contrast, and whatever LUTs you put at the bottom node will only affect the color tone, so that you can separately adjust the opacity of the LUTs and start working from there. There you have it, still a lot more effects I did not cover in this video. Like for some overlays, it requires you to manually download them from the website they provide, which gives you a lot more overlay to play. But I want to say that right now, Cinepunch only costs you $59 with over 10,000 assets and over 2,500 sound effects. You judge it yourself. Is it worth the price you have to pay or not? Links down below. But if you're still not sure whether it's the right choice or not, I recommend you watch this video where I show you how much work you need to do to create your own templates. And trust me, if you don't have time, you don't want to do it yourself. And as of today, hit the like button if you like this video and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you in the next one. Happy grading. Bye.